Let's pretend. You're the Department of Transportation, okay? Someone informs you that this company installs front seat mounting brackets that never pass collision tests, brake linings that fail after 1,000 miles, and fuel injectors that explode and burn people alive. What then?
Are you threatening me?
No, better solution. You keep me on the payroll as an outside consultant. And in exchange for my salary, my job will be never to tell people these things that I know. I don't even have to come into the office. I can do this job from home.
Security?
I am Jack's smirking revenge.
Oh! Oh! What the hell are you doing?
In the previous video, we talked about opportunity cost. That scene from Fight Club definitely gives us a chance to explore opportunity cost a little deeper, as well as look into some time equivalence and cost and utility. That guy had a few choices available to him. We could start with keeping his job, quitting his job, blackmailing his boss, going to the bar, reading a book, whatever. But the opportunity cost, the thing to keep in mind, is that it's the cost of the next best thing, that one thing that you didn't do. So while going to the bar and reading a book might be on there, that's really not what we mean by opportunity cost. Obviously, he chose to blackmail his boss. So therefore, the next highest value choice that he had available to him was keeping his job. Because as you can see with those green arrows that I drew, he would be making income every month from his job. Now from his perspective, clearly in the red arrows, I'm drawing some negative utility. Whether it's that he hates his boss, his job, whatever, there's some negative utility there. So when it came time for him to make his decisions, right, then he chose to blackmail his boss, which is to say he wants to try to keep the income that he's making, so keep the green arrows, while getting rid of the red arrows. If he had quit his job, then of course he wouldn't keep the green arrows, he wouldn't keep his income. So quitting his job is not the opportunity cost here. The opportunity cost is keeping his job, as well as keeping out of prison, maybe. Now in the last video, we had also talked about there being some utility, right, to watching that previous video, and hopefully this one. But there's also some opportunity cost, right? And so let's just go back to that and think about only two cases. One is going to the bar right now, and the other is watching this video. But we're going to think about the value of this going forward in time. So how much value was, let's say, the bar 6 months from now, right? You spent some money which you couldn't invest. You drank and added a little bit to your waistline and whatever. So I'm going to make the argument that having watched the previous video, learned about opportunity costs, the way to put a framework around decisions, like what you do with your time, that made a difference in how you approach future decisions. And so the utility of that previous video has actually grown, just like hopefully the utility of this video will have grown in 6 months. Whereas the bar, what you did 6 months ago, has diminished. The utility of that is diminished. Now let's return to that scene from Fight Club. So the boss's perspective, right? He has to look at value over time. Now if he doesn't comply with what's being asked, then he's going to have a rather large negative utility in the present, which I'll draw in red. But in order to avoid having that negative utility, which is essentially being turned in to the government for these violations, he has to pay this guy to be quiet, and he has to pay him a monthly salary every month, which I'll draw out in even increments. So I'll call those increments A. Now that A can be an annuity. Oftentimes you'll see, such as in the book, that it's represented as annual worth, but it's really even any even increment that's repeating. So it could be monthly, it could be quarterly or yearly. It's going to be AW or AV, the annual worth, the annual value, or the annuity value or annuity worth. So let's go back to this scenario in Fight Club and take a look at what the boss could be thinking, right? He wants to avoid that negative utility, that negative value, which could be a cost in many different ways. And so instead of letting this guy get paid every month just to be quiet, he could offer him a bribe. He could offer him and say, look, I'm not going to pay you indefinitely, but what I will do is I'm going to offer you money right now just to leave and to be quiet. Now, if he's going to do that and the other guy's going to accept, then he needs something that's of equivalent value to this AW, right? This recurring amount that the guy could be getting. And so that raises the question on whether or not there are times in which some future value is equivalent to a present value, right? Like, let's say he also says, look, I want you to leave right now and I'll offer you money a year from now, you know, or I'll offer you money right now. So if you're going to offer money right now, that's a present worth, right? Because it's in the present. Or if I'm going to offer you money a year from now or however many months from now, that's a future worth. So now we have an AW, PW, and FW referring to values that are different in time. And that brings to mind whether or not there are scenarios in which these values are equivalent. So if there's an opportunity cost for your time, there's an opportunity cost for your money, then how is it and in what circumstances can a future amount be equivalent to a present amount? Can I come to you and can I say, I'll give you $100,000 a year from now or $80,000 right now? Are those equivalent to you? And in what circumstances would they be? Let's say it's $100,000 and then I say you can have $100,000 divided by 15 months. Or, you know, is that equivalent? Well, that's not equivalent. I could do something with that money. I could invest it and make more money. I can just like the looks of it. You know, whatever the utility is to me. And so you have to incentivize me, right? You have to make up for that opportunity cost. And if I do say, okay, pay me in a year from now, or okay, pay me on a 15-month payment plan, there's something that could have been lost there, and you need to make it up for to me, whether that is interest to be made on investments, whether it's inflation and rising prices, whatever the case, you've got to do something about it. So let's go back to the Fight Club scenario, right? Let's say that the employee wants $100,000 to shut up and leave. And let's say that he's a decent investor and he can make 10% a year on his money. So he can make 10% more on his money. So let's draw that out. In present worth, he wants 100K now and he'll leave. But his boss is saying, I can't do that. So his boss says, I'll offer you $100,000, but it'll have to be a year from now. Now, quantitatively, those are the same amounts, but because of the time value of money, because there's an opportunity cost, because he could do something with it, then that's not the same. The present worth is not equivalent to the future worth. So then this guy's going to have to increase his offer and make it worth his while. So let's say he offers him $110,000 one year from now, and this guy can invest and he'll make 10%. So in the future, he would have $110,000 anyway. So now the present worth and the future worth are equivalent. But is that really going to incentivize him to take the money now or to take the money a year from now? You want to incentivize him to take the money a year from now, then you better offer something more. Since we know that the present worth and future worth are equivalent at $110,000, let's say we offer him $115,000. So now he's making $5,000 more than he would have made otherwise. You're $5,000 better than his opportunity cost. So let's look at how somebody could make this decision. All right, well, so let's draw a scale of percentage. And when I talk about percentage, we mentioned earlier the employee can make 10%. Well, let's draw this out and see where 10% would be on the scale. So at the bottom of the scale somewhere, there's going to be a cost of capital. Whether we borrow money or work for money or whatever, there's a cost to that money. So anything above that is making money. Anything below that is losing money. Now the question is, how far above the cost of capital do we target? How far above the cost of capital do we invest? Do we say, yes, this is something I want? So if we have $100 and we invest that and we make $10, then we've earned 10% interest, right? Or our rate of return is 10%. So for some of us, that would be great, and that's enough. We would invest in 10%. But for others, maybe you're a land developer, you know, maybe you're Warren Buffett. So maybe you want more. Maybe you want more than 10%. So there's some minimum that you demand before you will put your money into it. Otherwise the risk, otherwise the cost, otherwise the opportunity cost is not worth it to you. And so you can draw this out on the scale and put a line there. And that line is your minimum attractive rate of return. So anything below that, not worth it. Anything above that or equivalent, and that's where you're going to invest. Then it's worth it. Then it's a go. So let's look at this scenario and say, this is you and this is me. I'm going to lend you $100,000 and you're going to pay me back $110,000. So from your perspective, that 10% is an interest rate. Right? Let's say it's a 1-year term. So you have a 10% per year interest rate. Now, from my perspective, it's an investment. So that 10% is my rate of return, or my return on investment. It's the same, depending on which perspective you're looking at it from. And one thing you would know is that if I did the loan, then my MAR must be 10% or less. So returning back to Fight Club, right? He was demanding a salary. He was saying, look, I'll be quiet. I'll go home. I won't say anything, but you keep paying me. Now, from the boss's perspective, that's probably not such a great offer. So is there a scenario in which you put a time limit on that and you say, is there a present worth that's equivalent to that annuity, to that annual worth? Is there an amount that you can offer him that is equivalent or better to incentivize him to take the money now and disappear? In the next video, that's what we'll go over. We'll go over the math for these equivalents and how you can move money around in time based on a certain rate.
Computer, fax machine, 52 weekly paychecks, and 48 airline flight coupons. We now had corporate sponsorship. This is how Tyler and I were able to have Fight Club every night of the week.